Welcome to my YouTube channel, philippospan. Weekly tips and tricks on how to work with Microsoft Office applications. Be wise and subscribe.
Today's video will be about Microsoft Word.
How to restrict editing in a Microsoft Word document.
Sometimes when we have sensitive information in our Microsoft Word document, we can always take some actions to secure the document or even parts of the document. We can even make sure that only us and certain people can read it or edit it. We can mark a document as read-only and still allow changes to specific parts of the document. We can also notify the readers that this is the final version of the document.
I have created a Microsoft Word document where I need to restrict editing to it. I must select the Review tab and locate the area at the far right named Protect. In the Protect area of the Review tab, I select the command Restrict Editing where we can. Limit how much others can edit and format the document. For example, we can prevent formatting changes, force all changes to be tracked, or allow only commenting. By selecting the Restrict Editing command, the Restrict Editing task pane appears at the right of the Microsoft Word document. The Restrict Editing task pane is separated in three different areas. The first area is Formatting Restrictions, where we activate the checkbox at the right, we can limit formatting to a selection of styles. We can also select the Setting command beneath for further more adjustments. Once selected, the Formatting Restrictions dialog box appears. Here we can activate the checkbox at the left of the command, Limit Formatting to a selection of styles. Once activated, we are notified that, by restricting formatting to the styles we select, we prevent the ability to modify styles and the ability to apply direct formatting to the document. We can select the style we want to allow to be used in the document. Then from the area checked styles are currently allowed, we can either select all, select recommended minimum, or none. We can always activate or deactivate styles on our own by clicking on the check boxes at the left of each style. At the bottom of the Formatting Restrictions window is located the formatting area where we can activate the check boxes next to the command Allow Auto Format to override formatting restrictions, Block Theme or Theme Switching, Block Quick Style Set Switching. Whatever adjustments we make, we press the OK button for them to take place and to return to our document. The second area is Editing Restrictions, where we can activate the checkbox we can allow only this type of editing to the document. Once activated, from the drop-down menu we can select either No Changes, Read Only, Track Changes, Comments, and Filling In Forms. In this list I will select No Changes, Read Only. Then we select the part of the document that we want to allow changes. For example, we can select paragraphs, a sentence, a word, or even a heading. Under the Editing Restrictions area, the Exceptions, Optional, area gets activated. Here we can select parts of the document and choose users who are allowed to freely edit them. To allow anyone who will open the document to edit the part that we selected, we activate the Everyone checkbox. At the right of the Everyone checkbox, we can expand the drop-down menu and select from one of the following. Find next regions this user can edit, or all regions this user can edit, remove all editing permissions for this user. To allow only specific users to edit the part that we selected, we select the command More Users and then type in the usernames. The Add Users dialog box appears where we include our name if we want to be able to edit the part of the document. We also enter users' names separated by semicolons. Once finished, we press the OK button. Once we have assigned name of individuals, we select the checkboxes next to the names that we are allowing to edit the part of the document that we have selected. The third area is Start Enforcement. Here we are asked if we are ready to apply the settings and that we can turn them off later. Once selected, the Start Enforcing Protection dialog box appears. In this dialog box, we can select one of the two protection methods. Password. We can assign a password to the document, so that the users who know the password can remove their protection and to work on the document. We must enter a password and then confirm it. User authentication. We can activate this command to encrypt the document so only authenticated users can remove the protection. Whatever we select, we press the OK button to start enforcing the protection. Once we press the OK button, we are notified with the permissions in the Restrict Editing Task pane. We are notified that this document is protected from unintentional editing. Only us can view this region. In the middle of the Restrict Editing Task pane, we can select Find Next Region I Can Edit or Show All Regions I Can Edit. We can also activate or deactivate the checkbox at the left of the command, Highlight the Regions I Can Edit. That is it. We have successfully protected our document. We notice also that the most of the commands on the ribbon are faded out, which means that we cannot use them. We cannot either enter, delete, rearrange paragraphs, or do any other formatting on the document. Finally, at the bottom of the Restrict Editing Task pane, we can stop protection, where we will be prompted to enter the password that we used to protect the document, if we had entered one.
Thank you for watching. If you liked what you saw in this video, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, head down to the comment section and let me know.
Be wise and subscribe.